Well, just a couple of months ago, I sat down with John F. Kennedy Jr. for what turned out to be his last television interview. Who would have ever thought? The occasion was the Profile in Courage Award given out by John and his sister every year. As it happened, we did not broadcast everything from that interview, so we wanted to share the rest of it with you this morning. JFK Jr.'s last interview, May 1999. We were talking about his mom.
She parented for both of them, and I think she was deliberate in ensuring that his interests and his concerns were part of our upbringing, and some of her own, which were not his. And I think there was a dynamic there that was healthy.
Right. What were, when you say some of her own, what were?
No, I mean, she didn't come from a political family. I think there was a lot about politics and the life of politics, especially for young children, that she thought was heady stuff, and that it was better to have a sense of who you are and your own place in life before you really took that on. So that kind of healthy skepticism, I think, was an important part of her parenting and probably made my sisters and I life easy.
Right. Yeah, because, I mean, if you look at a lot of political families and a lot of families who grow up with the incredible glare of this spotlight that you all have, and you see you and your sister, you think, God, they're remarkably well-adjusted, or seem to be, you know, who knows?
Seem to be, exactly.
But, you know, I think it's a real tribute to your mom that you all turned out to be really nice, productive people.
Well, thank you. She would be glad to hear you say that. She took a lot of pride in being a good mother, and I'm glad people think it worked.
Yeah. We have a clip from a show called Look Here. We're going to look there and
sure.
Then talk about it.
If you were to have a son, would you encourage a political career for him?
Yes, and I hope if I had a daughter, I might encourage her to play some part. I don't know. I don't think this should be confined to men only, but I would definitely. I would hope he would grow up to be, if not a politician in the sense of devoting all of his time, I would hope that whatever he did do, that he would have some sense of responsibility for what went on.
When you hear him talk about that, do you ever feel like your choice not to pursue a career in public service might have disappointed him?
No, I can't imagine that he would have said anything different being asked that question under those circumstances. You know, he'd always said that he thought everyone should run for office. Listen, there's a lot of time in life to do all sorts of things. You know, the world was very different. Politics was a different profession back then. There are other ways to contribute to the public discourse. We all want to do it in the way that we participate in the way that we can.
So you feel as if you are doing that with your magazine in a way?
I guess
that,
so. I mean, you know, it's...
Well, don't
it's,
be it's, modest. I mean, it's a political magazine.
Yeah.
You bring up various issues.
Exactly. And I think everyone has to find their way into politics or any other professions on their own. Do it on their own speed and in their own way.
In their own timetable. That sure sounds like you haven't given up the notion of maybe going into politics.
Maybe not.
Oh, come on, John.
Hey, no one's ever asked me that question before.
Really?
No.
I know. I'm so original, aren't I? As you look back on your father's political career, what do you think his greatest legacy will continue to be? What are you proudest of him as a son?
Well, I'm enormously proud of you know, a lot of things. I was in Mount Rushmore the other day, and they do a vote of popular presidents, and among 18 to 25 year olds, he is the fourth most popular president. Now, all these are people who were not alive when he was president and know nothing about him except for what they see in the paper or read, you know, see on TV. And the fact that he still manages to inspire people, to make people think that public service is a good thing, that people are still interested in his life and how he got into politics, is something that I'm very proud of, that he has a resonance that has endured beyond his years. So you know, people come up to me and say, you know, your family or your father got me into politics or is a great man, and that, you know, that happens to me several times a day, and that's a really special thing.
John F. Kennedy Jr., his final television interview just 2 months ago.